I used to have a property just out of Wangaratta, a quite large property, which was developed from a very run-down, useless sort of land to one that won the environmental award for rural properties in Victoria. And now we're failed retirees out of Benalla, where we've got 100 acres running sheep and irrigation down there, yes, and a worm farm.
Now, I believe recently you were awarded an OAM, and yes, that had to do with your excellent work into conservation and the environment.
That's right. I've been involved in the environment most of my life, and I'm on quite a number of different boards and represented a number of people in the environmental area. Yes, so that's right, I did. And one of my big areas is peri-urban development, where the rabbits are totally out of control, and it's extremely difficult for people to be able to control them. They can't shoot, they can't poison, they can't rip, and it's so important to get the biological control back into the as soon as possible and get that going again to undertake these. Otherwise we're going to have huge build-up of rabbits where we're getting them now in these areas that are going to spread out into the rural areas as well.
And are rabbits impacting on your 100 acre block?
Yes, they are. We're along the Broken River, and the riverbank is pretty unstable, so we have problems ripping and getting rid of rabbits there. We can't use poisons because there's too many other neighbours around, and shooting's very difficult, and the rabbit population has bred up. Really looking forward to the biological control, to the release of the new Khaleesi virus, but also to make sure that people understand that that's not a silver bullet on its own. There have to be follow-up work with ripping and blowing up warrens and getting rid of them and revegetating. And then the other problem is, of course, is the animal liberationists, where they've got to work with us to understand the damage that rabbits are doing to not only for the farmers but to the natural environment. And a lot of native species are dying because the rabbits are eating out all their food source, and they've really got to think about what they're doing to try and stop these issues. This is one of the big problems. We've really got to be able to sell our story of what the damage that rabbits do, the terrible environmental damage, not only to the farmers with the loss of pasture and things like that, but the loss of the environmental in national parks and places like that. It's very, very severe.
So in northeast Victoria, is there a groundswell of landholders and producers who are actually working together across the landscape?
Yes, through the land care movement, we're working together in collaboration with a whole lot of groups in small areas, getting together and really getting stuck into getting rid of the rabbit problem, which is the best way to do it, because you've got to get on with your neighbours, you've got to work together. And it has to be a project where the government, the councils, the roads authorities, they have a lot of areas where rabbits are, and the rail, all got to work together and sit down and talk together and get a program that covers all those areas. And this is happening in the northeast. It's very exciting, really. But so that's very positive.